हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ ज्वाला प्रसाद चौरसिया, अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ ठाकुर कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, सेकेंड ईयर बीटेक एआईएमएल। टुडे वी आर गोना सॉल्व द 30 डेज ऑफ गूगल क्लाउड। द प्रोग्राम का फर्स्ट ट्रैक, क्लाउड इंजीनियरिंग ट्रैक का सेकेंड लैब, परफॉर्म फाउंडेशनल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर टास्क इन गूगल क्लाउड का थर्ड लैब। सो गाइज, लेट्स गेट रीडायरेक्टेड टूवर्ड्स द क्विक लैब्स। सो हियर आई हैव कम टू द क्विक लैब वेयर आई हैव सॉल्व द टू लैब्स अर्लियर, and you can find the videos in the playlist over there. And let's get into our third lab, cloud monitoring quick start. Okay guys, let's get into the overview of this section and let's see the setups and requirements. These are the basic setups and requirements, which is are gonna be like signing and all. Okay, so let's start the lab from here. I will copy the username. We'll copy the password. Next. No, so guys, these all the Google formalities are going on. It's been loading. Sometimes it's take time and it's going on like that. Chill, I'm sorry for my English. Sometime I talk rubbish, I know that. What's going on? Maybe some agreements are gonna come. Okay, ho jayega. It's done. What's going on? It's done. Now let's get into our first task, is create a compute engine instance. So we will get into it. Now we have to navigate to the compute engine and VM instance, then click a create instances. Okay, compute engine, we are getting to this, and VM instances, we have to create the virtual machine over here. And after getting into the VM instances, we have to create a VM instance. A button will appear over here. Wait, it's alright. Huh. Okay. Now we are gonna create instance. Guys, we are into it. Okay, we are into it. Now see the next step, we have to name this field as like this, which is given over here, lamp only, and its region as US central one and zone as US central one, and series is N1 and machine type is N1 standard 2 and allow HTTP traffic. Okay, region and zone are already been set. We have to set the machine type, which is N1, and machine type is already N1 standard one. N1, we have to set it to N1 standard 2. Okay, N1 standard 2, and we have to check the allow the HTTP traffic firewall over here. And after that, I have to create the VM instance. So guys, we are creating the VM instance over there. Guys, please share the video everywhere so that all the students of 30 days of Google Cloud Challenge can get access to this, and they can easily solve their labs with the help of this video. Our instance has been created. Now soon we will check the status of our lab. So till now, next step, and I will check that our first task is completed over here. Now we have to add an Apache 2 HTTP server to our instance. For that, we have to get into the SSH. Okay. I have clicked on the SSH wala server. Now this is coming. So we are establishing the connection with the SSH server. So we did it, guys. And after that, we have to copy these commands and the following commands in the SSH window to set up Apache to HTTP server. Simply copy this command and control V, paste. We are updating this. So guys, we did it. Now next command, we have to add Apache 2 with PHP 7.0. And guys, by clicking this, control V, enter. Okay, we have to yes it. Yes, we want to continue it. So it's going on, the process is going on. Sometimes this SSH server may have an issue because of the heavy load, and many of the guys were facing this issue. So that's why it's not a big thing. Sometimes it's make, but try it sometime early in the morning or late in the night, because at that time the traffic over internet is low. So we can try that. And now we have to restart our Apache 2 server. Okay. We did it, guys, and let's see, our second task is completed. Hooray, we completed our second task. Now we have to return to the cloud console on the VM instance, and we have to check that Apache 2 has been started or not by clicking on the external IP. Okay, guys, we can see that we have started with it. Done. What's our next step? We got a success response. We have completed this also, guys. Now next step. In the cloud console, click navigation menu and monitoring. Navigation menu. Okay. Where is monitoring? Search for it, guys. Where is monitoring? Monitoring. Kaha hai? We got it. We are in the monitoring wala menu. It's been loading, guys. We are over here, and in the wait for a workspace to be, when the monitor dashboard opens, your workspace is ready. Install the monitoring and logging agents. Okay, run the okay for installing agents on the VM. In the virtual machines, we have to run these commands. Run the monitoring agent install script command in the SSH terminal of your VM instance to install the cloud monitoring agent. We have to simply copy this command and run this command in our VM, in the SSH wala server. Enter. Okay, guys, we are done with it. Now next, second command, we have to update it. Okay, done. We have to install the stack driver agent. Yes, I want to continue. Guys, command kya kya dash y bhi dal dete ho na, to apne aap continue ho jata hai. Okay. And now these commands. We have to run the logging agent install script command in the SSH terminal of a VM instance to install the cloud logging agent. So, copy this command, simply paste it. Okay, it's been done. Now again update it. It needs an update. Okay, guys. Update done. Now install the Google Fluent D. It's been going on, guys. It's been unpacking the Google Fluent D package in the SSH terminal. It may take some time, but it will be done within some seconds or within some minutes. Okay, it's been going on. We are installing it. We are done with it. Now what? What's the next step? We have to create an uptime check in the cloud console in the left menu. Click uptime check and then click create uptime check. Okay, यार दे हैव टू गो इन द अप टाइम चेक वाला मेन्यू, हैव टू क्रिएट एन अप टाइम चेक. सो सेट द फॉलोइंग थिंग्स, टाइटल lamp, where the title should be as lamp uptime check. Simply copy this, paste the title over here, and lamp next, and HTTP protocol, resources type instance, HTTP protocol, resources type is instance, applies to single lamp 1 VM, applies to single lamp. Okay, let's see from here. There it is. Instances simple lamp 1 VM, simple lamp. Okay, it's been done over here. And path leave by default, check frequency 1 minute. Check frequency is 1 minute, and after that, check frequency 1 minute. Click on next to leave the other details to default, and click on test to verify that your uptime check can connect to the resource. Okay, I will be checking on next. I'll be checking on test, that it's on default. Okay, and after that click create. So we are creating the uptime check wala menu over here. Then after that we have to create an alerting policy. In the left menu, click alerting and then click create policy. We have to click on here alerting, and we have to click create policy from here. Okay, click add condition. Set the following the panel that opens. Leave all other fields at their default values. Okay, click on add conditions. Okay guys, we are here at the adding condition. Start VM in the resource type and metric field, and then select VM instance. Okay, we are here, we got it, VM instances, and VM instances, metric, type network, and select network traffic. We say be sure to choose network traffic resource with metric में network. Okay, and then select network traffic. Okay guys, wait, I will select it. Sometimes this takes some time to come over here. Okay, network traffic. Okay, which one was it? Slash network, right? Okay, slash traffic. This one. We did it, guys. Okay, configuration. Condition should be is above. Now configuration. Okay, after what was the step after that? Configuration. Condition is about configuration. Condition is about threshold is 500. And for 1 minute. Okay, after that I have to click add and click on next. Click on next. Who should be notified? Click on the drop down next notification channel and click on manage notification channels. Okay, manage notification channels. We are over here managing the notification channel. Wala part. Don't be confused guys, it's very simple. It's just like doing the steps as it is given in the labs. After that, scroll down the page and click on add new for email. Okay, over here, there is email wala part. This is email. You click on add new and in create email channel dialog, enter your personal email address and display a name. Okay, I will add my personal name. Chorasia 38@gmail.com and I will display my name as Swala. Save. So guys, we did it. And after that, click on save. Go back to the previous, click collect policy tab. We are over here. Okay. Click policy tab. Click on notification channel. Click on the refresh icon. Notification channel. Refresh icon. And then select notification channel. Refresh icon. To get the name you mentioned. Okay. Select your display name and click on OK. I selected it and I will click on OK. And what? Click next. Mention the alert name as inbound traffic alert. Now what? Click on next. Mention the alert name as inbound traffic alert. I will simply copy this from here. I will paste here and add a message in the automation which will include in the email alert. Hey guys, thank you guys. Please share my video. Please share my video. Okay, I just did it and I will click on save. And boom guys, we have completed our this third lab also very successfully and very much easily. As you can see that we have created the policy inbound traffic alert has been saved, and you can see that we have got the check mark also over here. Yeah, and we have got the all the 100 points very easily and successfully. Okay, let's go guys. Okay, taking time, let's do a share. We are done with it. I think some net issues there. It will be resolved. Okay, all we have actually we have finished the lab, just it's a network issue and we will be ending. I think we have done with it and we have completed each and everything over here. Now simply I will end the lab, and by this we completed our third lab also guys, and thank you so much for watching my video. And soon I will be posting the fourth lab and fifth lab and also the challenge lab. So guys, till tomorrow, our second quest is also gonna be finished. Thank you so much guys for watching my video. Thank you so much.